Windows Media Player 9 is the last Windows Media Player that is officially compatible with Windows 2000. In today's video, I will demonstrate Windows Media Player 11, which is the last supported Windows Media Player for Windows XP, running on Windows 2000 with extended kernel. So, go to the Microsoft Update Catalog, catalog.update.microsoft.com, and search for Windows Media Player 11. As you can see, you will get a bunch of updates. Download the Windows Media Player 11, not the Media Center edition, but the normal Windows Media Player 11 update. As you can see, it will open a dialog box and you can follow the link to download the file. I have already transferred it to my Windows 2000 virtual machine. And we can start installing the player. As you can see, again, this is an XP patch and we will run it on Windows 2000. So if you run the file, as you can see that the version of Windows Media Player can only be installed on 32-bit Windows XP operating system, but the program KDW FcWin2k is here to help. Drag the file to the FcWin2k and then open it as Windows XP SP3. Click on Run Compat and it will extract some files, as you can see, including the setup wizard. So now you can click on Validate, it will hang, you can try again afterwards, and then you will go to the OOB. And you can click on Accept to accept the license agreement. Then the setup wizard will show two error messages. Despite them, I still have Windows Media Player 9. I'll show you. I will also want to say it's important to run the official installer and accept the agreement, else the first run experience after installing it will be interrupted by genuine validation. Now I will show you how to install Windows Media Player 11 manually. As you can see, just once again, Windows Media Player 9 series is still on this machine. So, remember when the installer was extracting some files? Let's run it again with KDW. Drag it, select the compatibility settings from OSVR and run compat. As you can see, it is extracting some setup files. So now don't close the installer and go to your C drive, open the search, and search for IXP. When you click on search now, it might take some time, but in the end it will find the following folder, IXP000.tmp. Right click and choose open containing folder, and exploring the contents, you can see some interesting files, such as the setup wizard for Windows Media Player and Windows Media Player 11 format runtime. Copy this folder to your documents, because it might get deleted if you close out of the installer. So, let's go to the documents folder and I will paste it here. As you can see, then you can close out of the installer and you can start extracting the files in your IXP000.tmp. folder. Now first run WMF dist 11. As you can see, it extracts some more files, but there's an error message. Don't close out of the error message, else the files will be deleted. Then go to your C drive and there will be some long string of characters and numbers. As you can see, open the folder and you can find the setup wizard for the Windows Media Player 11 format runtime. However, if you try to copy this folder, as you can see, there will be a sharing violation. I don't know if newer Windows versions do this, but this is Windows 2000 and I mean, there's nothing we can do about it. So, how do you preserve these files? If you kill the task, it will delete them. If you close the dialog box, it will also delete them. So right-click on the process in Applications and choose Go to Process, then don't kill it, but instead find WMF Disk 11 and choose to end this process. Then even closing out of the error message with the OK button leaves these files. Now you can run in the update folder, you can run the update.exe installer. Of course, with KDW, or it will generate the error. Again, choose Windows XP SP3, run compat, and as you can see, now you can install Windows Media Format 11 runtime. Click on Next and wait for the setup wizard to finish. As you can see, the wizard has successfully installed WMF Dist 11. Now repeat the steps for WMP 11. I will minimize FcWin2k, then you can go to your Documents folder, open the same IXP000 temp and run WMP 11. You will get another error message and some more extract files to install. Now, sometimes it might name them similarly, so I'm not sure if this was the folder. You can see from properties which one has been created earlier, and you can open the other one. Yes, this one is earlier, so it must be the other one. Now, repeat the steps with Task Manager, since it will generate another sharing violation. Right-click on the process, then click on Go to Process, and just this time don't kill WMF Dist 11, but instead WMP 11. Now close out of the error message, and the files will be left in your C drive, then run update.exe in the update folder, of course with KDW. And as you can see, this is the setup wizard for Windows Media Player 11. Wait for it to finish, and then you can check your start menu and see if Windows Media Player is installed. As you can see, it has successfully installed WMP 11. You can finish, now you can close out of FcWin2k, and as you can see, checking the start menu, Windows Media Player 11 is installed. Now, this is the reason I want you to run the official installer and let it fail, because here you can customize the installation or you can choose express options. This will be interrupted by the genuine validation screen if you don't run it. Now, as you can see, I'm demonstrating Windows Media Player 11 running on Windows 2000. I also want to show you the mini mode feature. Let's just open clog.avi, which is a media file present on all Windows versions until XP, I think, or at least most of them. Yes, as you can see, full screen, and it works perfectly fine. I think the mini mode also works, but it doesn't work on the first time. You need to reopen the Windows Media Player 11 application and replay the audio file, and then the mini mode will work, as you can see. And of course you can get some slight glitches with the mini mode, like a GDI plus window appearing on your taskbar. However, I mean, Windows Media Player 11 is not officially compatible with Windows 2000, so some slight bugs are expected, and for now it is running pretty stable and I couldn't find any issues with it. And yes, that's it. Thanks a ton for watching. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Windows Media Player 9 series is a very nice media player. It has a lot of functions, nice skins, and also some dark mode.